Welcome back to Junior Mustangs TV, Eric Kadrax Communications. I got Adam Grandy, Western Ontario linebacker coach, part of the recruiting team at Western. Adam, thank you for coming out today.
Thanks very much for having me. It's good to be a fun day.
Adam, you know, you're recruiting in a weird time. It's COVID. What are some of the things you're looking to find today and even in your endeavors in this weird time of COVID?
Well, it's definitely a weird time because there is no in-person recruiting, right? So I can't even talk to any of the players here. So more or less for us, we know a lot of the players just from being local here. It's more just trying to see maybe some of the younger players to kind of see, you know, their athleticism, you know, because it's different here. They're not wearing pads either, right? So just trying to see how they move, you know, how they interact, how they take coaching, all that kind of stuff. But it's definitely an interesting time for recruiting for sure.
Okay, so Adam, I'm a young guy. I'm in grade 11.
Yep.
Give me some pointers on what I should be doing, what I shouldn't be doing in the recruiting process as a young guy.
I think first things first, take care of the academics, because that has to be number one. If you can't qualify for university, it all doesn't matter. The next best thing would be just try to stay in best shape if possible. If you can, try to put together your film. Everyone's on social media now, so just try to follow coaches on social media and start interactions with them. But, you know, on the other end, the coaches, we're trying our best to identify those players as well. We're talking to your coaches, so make sure, you know, take care of your school, make sure you just keep on grinding and working hard.
Well, listen, that's Adam Grandy. Thank you for joining us today on Junior Mustangs TV. I know you want to get out here and watch some of these games. Have a great day. Thanks for being here today.
Awesome. Thanks so much for having me.
championship at Flag Purple. You guys won a captains. Here's the trophy. And you guys can just jump up and yell into our cam here, just like they do on Monday Night Football, Sunday Night Football. All right, right here, guys. Jump right up into that cam. Give us a...
Yeah!
That's not gonna, yo, lift him up.
All right, can you guys line up? We're going to give you your trophies. Matt, I'll get you with the interviews with a couple of your guys in a minute. Team White, bring it in. Team White, come on in. Let's go. Coach Greg, just kind of I'll take a knee here. Coach Greg, if you come here. So, Coach Greg, take a knee, guys, real quick. Great season, Team White. You guys have to work through the wild card and get to the finals. Greg, talk about Flag. I know it's not tackle, but a great bunch of kids here. You guys did a great job with them.
Yeah, you know, it was a great opportunity for everyone to come out here and play ball. You know, otherwise, we wouldn't have had any season, right? So it's better to work, be out here, work on our fundamentals, have some fun, good competition. So it was a great season. Yeah,
it's tough for tackle football players who want to hit people like this guy right over here and a couple of the other guys. But great season. Greg, COVID, crazy time. And your guys came in. You guys were a wild card team, and you made it to the finals. I think it's a pretty good accomplishment.
Absolutely. We made it tough on ourselves, but you know what? We came in here knowing we were going to play 1-2 and probably number 3, and you know, we won 2 out of 3 today. So I'm really proud of how everyone played. We really
All right.
came out.
Yeah. I want to get you. Get up here. This kid here, he played probably made two of one of the craziest plays, one in the other game with a catch in the end zone, Keyshawn, and that little spin move you did on Peters. Talk about that play.
I don't even know much about it. I just did. I have instincts. It's my instincts.
Yeah. You get that from me or your old man?
My old man.
Come on, man. How much? I've been coaching you since you're
Yeah, you used to tell me. You used to teach me and all that when I was younger. But
It's my old man. Great job today, Keyshawn. Cristiano coming up here. Cristiano, you came late to the team, but you played pretty good here today. Talk about the day and the flag football experience.
I was just trying my hardest. You know, ran my routes good at all times. You know, always pushing to get that last extra yard and fight for that first down. And, you know, I'm really proud of these guys today. We played really hard and we overcame first place team, second place team. Unfortunately, not the last game, but we've all played good together.
Great job, Tyler Tierney. And then I'll get the Dahlberg brothers and Ethan and then we'll be done, guys. Thank you guys for all of your efforts this year. Tyler, you know, you played for every team, I think. I think you played every game this year, some nights at Flag. Talk about the experience.
It was fun. Good out here. I'm just glad we had a season because high school's canceled. But, you know, it sucks to come second, but it was good.
All right. Dahlberg brothers, come on up quick. Thank you, Tyler. Guys, your mom was involved in the scheduling. Talk about Flag real quick.
It was an awesome experience. I just want to thank London Junior Mustangs for putting it on when there was nothing else to do.
You know, it was nice to come play flag football out with the boys. You haven't seen them in a while. It's nice to meet them all and play some good old flag football together.
Awesome. Ethan Chambers, coming up here. Most of you know this is my nephew, and I'm damn proud of you, son. Great season. What did you think of flag football this year?
It was a fun experience. It was definitely different, not the same, but it was a lot of fun to get out here and play with all the guys.
All right, well, that's Team White, our runner-up in varsity. Great season. Congratulations, guys. Lost in overtime. Don't hang your heads. We'll see you in our winter camps. Take care, guys. What a game. You know, great season of flag football. You and I kind of were on the fence about whether we wanted to do this, and just talk about the whole process and today.
Yeah, it was a fun experience. When it kind of started, I wasn't sure how it was going to go, but it's one of those things, like, when you get out here, it's super competitive. You want to win, and then when the games are over, I think the guys go and shake hands with each other and they get to be buddies with their friends or buddies. But it's competitive. Great game today. Go to overtime. It's pretty good. And we played those guys a couple times this season and they got good players. And I think the best thing I thought about it was everybody enjoyed it. It was safe. The kids were safe out here. I felt like the organizers did a great job making sure that all the protocols were adhered to, which is awesome. The kids enjoyed it. They had a good time. I saw players getting better. I saw guys on our team improving, guys on another team improving. So overall, great experience. I mean, I think we all want to be playing football, but if we can't, this is the best thing we can do. And I think it worked out well, and hopefully we can kind of keep this opportunity going. So I really enjoyed it.
Absolutely. You got a couple guys here. Let's bring them in, Matt. Come on in, guys. You're going to have to introduce me to some of them. Cause
we're going
to
bring in
who's first?
Ben, our defensive MVP of the game.
All right. So Ben, MVP of the game defensively for Purple. Talk about today's game.
We had lots of fun, good teamsmanship. We were working hard, and that's what's most important, is keeping good with your team and trying to improve each play.
What high school do you go to, Ben?
I go to Central.
Central?
Yeah, not
Central. So no senior football, so at least you're out here playing. Do you think maybe you'll play next spring in the Junior Mustangs program?
Yeah, I might.
All right.
After this, yeah.
All right, well, Ben, congratulations. And I got a good friend of mine here. It's funny, I mentioned Ethan Chambers. Matt Jaquith and Ethan were on the same Thunderbird team that Matt got me involved. Actually, Matt brought me out to the Thunderbirds. I met Matt through flag football. And Matt, you know, I remember that year it was you and Ethan, and you went to play soccer. But, you know, you guys, unfortunately, there wasn't in the city final last year, but you won that game. And you won today. Talk about the flag experience.
Yeah, so the overall flag experience was great. Great to have guys out here getting reps in, you know, when usually we couldn't during the circumstances. Team really came together today and all season. We knew this was a good team going in, and we were just able to beat them out in the final minutes. So.
Well, Matt, you know, you've got a big decision to make. This is your last year, and hopefully you'll play the Junior Mustangs next spring, we're hoping. I'm hoping for sure. but, you know, that process is one thing, but you know, talk about your high school career. I mean, you were at Lucas, you won the city championship last year, and COVID kind of took your last year out. But, you know, just talk about your high school career.
Yeah, so started going to Lucas in grade 9, you know, worked my way up. Finally, by grade 12, which was last year, we were able to win city finals first, and then Wausau. So that was great for everyone. 4 years in the making, we were, you know, lost grade 9, lost grade 10 and 11. Then grade 12, we were able to catch it. So with everyone there, it was a great experience for sure to we'll get that.
Well, Matt, you're a great young prospect, a great man, not just a football player. Appreciate we wish it. You all the best here on Junior Mustangs TV.
Appreciate it.
All right, take care, Matt. Thank you. That's Matt Jaquith, and I've got a few last awards to give out to some of our
Junior
Mustangs TV. And I've got two special people here, obviously Allison Clelo, someone who's been in our program for a long time, and my wife, who allows me to do this. And so... I had to make sure, you know, if I'm getting all these ladies flowers, but this is actually from Uncle Louie. He wanted us to do this. He's in palliative care. He's not doing very well, folks. We love him. He always did the carnations for the Mother's Day. We didn't have football this year on Mother's Day. So if we could present Allison with her flowers.
Thank you, Allison.
And that's for Allison. And this is for my beautiful wife, Michelle, and all that she puts up with and allows me to do with these kids. And thank God she's still with me. I would not be here without her. So ladies, thank you very much. And Uncle Louie, we love you. Say hi to Uncle Louie, and we'll sign off with that. Thank you, guys.
These post-game interviews are brought to you by Battlefield Equipment, Mama's Hot Italian Sandwiches, Air K Jax Communications, and London Junior Mustangs Football Program.